let's have a look at this. So we test the capacitance. So this one here is 220 2200 microfarad capacitor. It's a little bit low. ESR is 0.31, which is quite good for what it is. So that's the first one. So again, we've got another 2200 capacitor. It's always a good idea to discharge your capacitor before. Testing it. That one's a little better. ESR 2.0, so that one's a little bit higher, but it's not. It's still in range. I'm just trying to see whether there's anything that jumps out on me. Again, this is a 2200, but this is a 16-volt one. So, that's why it looks a bit smaller. Right, now this is coming up as a resistor. So I have a feeling that this is bad. I have a feeling that this capacitor is faulty. Let me just have a look at my other one again. Right, so, we have had something that jumps out on us. This capacitor has gone short internally. And that's the reason why it's not working. Let's have another go. Okay, so this is coming up as a resistor, 0.24 ohms. So this is basically dead short. Okay, so I'm going to stop right there. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to order some new capacitors for this unit, and we'll be replacing these capacitors one by one, and then after that we will then see if it still doesn't power up. We will then start checking voltages. I think it's best for me to replace the capacitors first, because there may be others that are shorted as well, so I can possibly have a look at this one. This is a 47 microfarad. We can possibly have a look at this one as well. Okay, so that's not bad. 47. Right. So, I think for the first session of this video, we will conclude that the first thing that we need to do on this is replace the capacitors. Now, there are a few of them in there, so what I will do is I will make a list, and I will then try and replace these caps, because I believe that this unit has not been used for a very, very long time, and that is probably the reason why that capacitor has gone short circuit. Now, I just want to just trace where this capacitor has actually, where this is, because it goes through that resistor, goes through the diode, straight from the transformer. Straight in the transformer, and then after that it goes in here, and it goes to this transistor here, so it might be a good idea for me to check this transistor as well. This is a B772. IC902, it might be a good idea to check that as well. So, what we'll do, let me just go and put my battery back in here. So take that out. I had to take the battery off the my meter because I just want to make sure that I order everything together. Okay, so let's just put this battery back in. That's where I got it from. Okay. I just want to check that transistor as well, just to make sure that we're not getting a short circuit. My glove has torn. Never mind, I'll be washing my hands. Right, so we just need to make sure that that's the base. We have to put it in diode test mode. There's no short. I just wanted to check just to make sure. No, there's no short on any of these transistors. Okay, so that's the conclusion for today. We will be recapping this board. Well, obviously today is Saturday the 3rd of April. Now, it's Easter weekend, so I have to wait a little while before I get the capacitors back. I would want to replace all of the capacitors in here, because if it's been sitting around for a very long time, I'm sure, you know, something else might fail in the future as well. So, okay. There's not really that many here. And the values on here, that's 1 microfarad, that's 1 microfarad, 47, 47, that's 47, that's 10, 1 microfarad, I think that's probably 100 mic maybe. That's also 47. So we've got 47, that's 33. That's 33. Yeah, so that's it. That's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. This is my first video, so I'm sure, you know, we'll get used to each other. Please like, share, and especially subscribe so that my new channel can grow. Thank you very, very much, guys. And if you're watching before Easter, I just want to wish everyone a very, very happy Easter. Stay safe. Thank you.